Holder? Tupac? Tupac Holder?
You funny.
That wasn't Ray J. You can't be serious. That wasn't Ray J. That wasn't him. That wasn't Willie Norwood Jr. That wasn't him. That wasn't Brandy Brothers.
So
that wasn't Mo to the E to the that little nigga from that show. That wasn't that nigga, man.
So he called to the morning show today, and obviously you heard what happened, man. We just want to hear your side of the story, man.
I mean, really, like, you know, this is not no big thing to me. You know what I'm saying? Like, it is what it is at this point. This is more a war on drugs than a war between Ray J and me. You know what I'm saying? This nigga's high and coked up or on pills. And, you know, his rant, I heard this hilarious to me, first and foremost, joke to me. Like, it's not, I'm taking it serious on the side of where he thinks that I'm the that he should do that to. But I'm laughing at his whole character. Like, there's nobody that believes Ray J is gangster to that point unless he's going to prove it. So at this point now, he's going to have to prove all of this funny that he was saying on World Star, I mean on The Breakfast Club. But what really happened is, I'm sure people seen on Twitter, you know what I'm saying, we had some fun with him. Floyd had a 24/7. Show for the fight, you know what I'm saying? I guess Ray J was on the show.
Right.
And on the show, Floyd goes, I'm about to have a concert in my living room, you know what I'm saying? So from there, the camera cuts to Ray J singing on a piano, singing, and the shit was just funny to me, you know what I'm saying? I made a couple jokes about it on Twitter, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, I guess people on Twitter have fun with it. You know, Twitter, that's what Twitter does. They have fun with shit, so they had fun with it. Now, I came to Vegas for the fight. I went to, Diddy had a dinner. Diddy had a dinner.
Yeah,
at,
I was there.
You know what I mean? You was there, right? You
right,
were
right.
There. All right, okay. So, Ray J comes to the dinner. Ray J pops up at the dinner, and, you know, when Ray J came in, he like, oh, Fab, you got me on Twitter. You know, we laughed about it. You know, we joked about it. Kevin Hart was there. Diddy was there. These are all people who are all in this situation. They know exactly what's going on. You were there, DJ Clue. You know, you're the guy who can squash this.
The negotiator.
I know that's your man. I know Little Brandy is your man. You know what I'm saying? So that's why, you know, I wanted to call you and clarify this, because according to him, you're the only man that can squash it. You're the Minister Farrakhan of this. So, you know what I'm saying? But anyway.
Chris Sabian.
So anyway, comes into the dinner, and, you know, we laugh about it. He chopped it up about it. And what he said was the way they edited the 24/7 show. He said it was mad there. It was people there. It was everybody was in the living room. It still was funny. We still were joking, and we still were telling them, don't do any concerts in their living room, and don't do any shows in people's basements. You know what I mean? Like, that's not where we want to see his career go. You know what I'm saying? So we all laughed about that, joked about it. He was cool. He sat down. He ate some chicken. You know what I'm saying? Everything was cool. Everything water under the bridge. I have a show here at the Palms with Jada Kiss and Styles P. And I see him, and he's like, yo, we gonna come down to the show later. Everything's cool. I'm like, shit, cool. I'll see you at the show. Whatever. We get to dinner. I get to dinner. I went to dinner before the show. I see Kevin Hart. He said, yo, I just seen Ray J. He got on a little red hoodie, and he just told him, yo, we got seven Rolls Royces, and, you know, the is on deck. We just get money out here, the money team, the money. He just talking crazy, whatever. He said, okay, Kevin Hart said, I just looked at him and said, okay, and dapped him and walked off. You know what I'm saying? So we laughed about that, da 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 da. But I had no feeling that Ray J had any problems with me whatsoever. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So we go to the show. I'm walking down the hallway to the show. I see Kiss. I say, what's up to Kiss? As you come down the hallway, seeing everybody there, I see 50 against the wall. I see Floyd against the wall. And I see Brandy's brother with the red hoodie on. You know what I'm saying? Because Kev just told me he just seen him with the red hoodie. So I walk up. I get 50 at that. I'm going to get Floyd at that, and then Ray J chimes in and says, yo, my nigga, we here with the money team. I'm here with the money team, and you know, we was talking about the jokes and wasn't feeling the jokes. So I'm thinking, like I'm laughing. Like, I'm thinking he's continuing to talk or something from the dinner, you know, and still making more joke of it and probably bringing it back up. I felt the joke was over, but I'm laughing with him anyway, you know, just to not make him look stupid, you know what I'm saying? So
right, right.
I go to speak to Floyd, but he's still, like, chiming away over in my ear. So I look back over to hear what he's saying. He's like, yo, yeah, Nick, real Nick. And he loves to make this rant about seven rules worth outside and bitches by the pool and, you know, and all his whatever, he's whatever, which means to me. So, you know, he's saying this at this time. So I'm like a Ray J. You know, I don't know what he's talking about, whatever. So now I look over at 50, and 50's just looking, and they're looking like they're just trying to see what Ray J is talking about. So now I look back over to Ray J. Ray J is like, yo, we real, man. We're not bitch-ass niggas. This is the money team. This is this, that, and the third. And I'm just like, hold on, hold on. So now I'm looking at him in his eyes, and I'm starting to feel like, is he serious? Like, what's going on here? Are you serious, nigga? So I asked him, I'm like, yo, like, Ray J, what's wrong with you, man? Like, are you serious? What are you talking about? So he like, nah, because this real getting this money fast, getting money out here, man. You know what I mean? We on the West Coast, we mobbing, we getting money. I'm like, yo, seriously, Ray J, man? Like, I don't know what you're talking about right now. I don't know what's going on. I don't know what show he's talking about. The money team is right here, Floyd and 50. I said, yo, this don't really got nothing to do with Floyd and 50. I don't know what you're talking about, but this is me and you. Like, what are you talking about? And he's starting to say, like, he's still saying, so I'm like, yo, all right, Ray J. All right, man. Like, if you're serious, like, yo, don't, because while he's talking to me, he's, like, touching my shoulder and, like, tapping me on the chest and, like, you know, just talking. So I'm like, yo, if you're serious, like, let's this end this. Like, don't, first of all, don't touch me no more. Don't touch my body in any form or way. Don't touch me. So he's like, what you mean don't touch you, fam? And I said, what I just said, they don't touch me. You know what I'm saying? And then from there, he leaned back, and then he, like, pushed off of me at my chest. So then when he pushed off of me, I jumped back to him and I grabbed him up. So I grabbed him up. It was no fight. It was no swing. This whole story that he made up, that whole Tupac rant about him swinging on somebody and all of that shit, is all lies. It's all lies.
So there was never.
On that Whitney, that was on that Whitney last night or something. Like, that. Ain't no swings take place. You can ask the money team. The money team was standing there. Ask his money team. That he's probably the water boy for, but ask the money team. Ask the money team and let them, and they will tell you that it was no blows or what's this. So I grab him up by his little red hoodie, and I'm holding him there by his hoodie, and I'm like, just chill out, little Red Riding Hood. There's nothing going, like, just chill the fuck out, right? So I'm holding the nigga, and it's a bunch of commotion from all of the security guards and that. The hoodie is over his face. Like, I could have mopped the floor with this kid if I really wanted to. The hoodie's over his face. I'm just holding him. I didn't even swing on him. Like, I wasn't trying to, you know, I wasn't trying to Ortiz while he was a hoodie over. So everybody chilled out. They calmed it down. Everybody like, yo, just chill out, just chill out. I let his hoodie go, push him back. He's behind his security dude, screaming at the ceiling, you know what I mean? I went in my, and throughout the whole altercation, the only thing that happened was my shades fell off or some shit like that. My shades got lost in the whole little scuffle thing or whatever. So I went to my dressing room, which was 2 feet down from where this happened. Went in my dressing room, had a couple sips of Fiji water, you know, we joked about it in there. Me, Kevin Hart, and Meek Mill. Meek Mill came out to the show. Shout out to Meek Mill and Kevin Hart. You know what I'm saying? We joked about it for a little bit. I went on stage maybe about 10 minutes after that, did my show. I actually did a show with no shades on. Like, I didn't,
the crowd
didn't even know none of that happened, but I never performed without my shades.
Yeah,
so
I was crazy.
Just that I didn't have no shades, I just performed. So if anybody wanted, he told the Breakfast Club that my face is f***ed up and my, like, there's nothing wrong with my face. Unless I got a great plastic surgeon who worked in a cut last hour or so, like, there was who can work in that quick of time, there's nothing wrong with my face. You know what I'm saying? He didn't swing. it's not happening. Ray J is not swinging. That, and that's in the same sentence don't even sound right. So the interview was very entertaining, and he, you know, he sounded like, he didn't sound believable, but it sounded good. It was funny. I woke up to it. I had, it was very funny. He said a couple gay, funny things in there. I'm not even going to even, like, you know, I didn't drop your top, pause. That's not, no dropping, no top went anywhere. None of that happened. You know, I don't know what kind of niggas you roll with that say that rape and all that, but they're not raping anybody over here on this side. And it's just a big story that he's, you know, like, he's, I don't know. I don't, I, up until this point, Ray J was an associate of mine in the industry. You know, I know him and his sister and never really had a problem with him. I didn't have a problem with him when I seen him. I don't know if this was fueled by him trying to prove himself for the money team. But, you know, the real story is that you can't, there's cool niggas and there's real, and you can't mix them with lame. You know what I'm saying? And that's what this got to stop. Like, you got to stop. I don't want to be around no lame no more. Like, they, I don't want them even around me. You know what I'm saying? There's the cool and the real and the lame nigga. Stay with you. I don't care if you got money. Being a lame, it's a lame nigga. If you got money, you just a lame with money, and that's it. There's no mixture. You don't, it don't make you cool because you lame, but you got money. You just a lame, and that's it. I don't do what he does. He doesn't do what I do. You know, he can continue to do reality shows and do his thing and do that, and I can continue to do what I do. If he want to pursue it further than that, that's not for media. That's not an interview at 6:30 in the morning, calling up, trying to, what's the name? Like, my hood won't let be allowed to get any Ray J. I don't even get no points off of Ray J. If you've never heard of any of this type of shit ever happening. So, you know, it was a good, funny story, cool story, you know what I mean? Good joke. You know, it could be a movie one day. Probably not. But at the end of the day, there's no way that Ray J is getting off on me. No way. Never, ever happened. Ever. Ever.
So, is there any way we can squash this, man?
No, it's nothing to squash. I don't have a, like, he's talk, like, you know, like I said, we could progress in our own ways. I could go my way, he could go his way. He could continue playing the piano at Floyd's crib if he wants, and I'll continue to do what I do, you know what I'm saying? And he could do concerts and living rooms all he wants. That's his prerogative. But at the end of the day, like, I don't gotta mix in with him, you know what I'm saying? So he could do his thing, I do my thing. If he wants to take it on a different path, which he ain't really about, but if he want to take it, if he want to go there, then it could go there, but it won't go there through the media. It's already amplified on Twitter and on radio about people have heard his little story. Like, I was not going to pay this attention, but I don't want people in the back of their mind thinking maybe I'm being silent because Ray J actually, there's some smart people in the world that don't believe this whole little story, but there's some people that don't know. So I had to speak on it. But it's nothing to squash, you know what I mean? I know you're, you know, Clue Farrakhan is trying to
put Sabian, the squash. Clue Sabian.
Yo, listen, whatever, Clue Sabian, whatever you trying to do here. But
I could talk a bird down from a tree.
Squash. And it could be, it's...
Yo, Fat Man, I appreciate you calling in, man. Look, man, you know I'm a good person, man. I could talk a cloud down from the sky. So I'm going to try to work on this and get this whole thing squashed.